Now, before I invite Professor Behar to speak to us, I just thought I'd make one or two very, very broad points. As some of you may perhaps know, I was in Jammu and Kashmir for a considerable period. And in my capacity as governor of the state, according to the laws of the state, I was the chancellor of 4 state universities, chancellor of 1 Shrine Board, Mata Vaishno Devi University, and the President of India had appointed me as chancellor of the founder chancellor of the Central University of Jammu when it was founded. My own experience and observations, very, very rough and very quick, is that education is in the concurrent arena, in the concurrent list of our constitution. And since we are a large country, large student population, large basic population, large issues of coordination arise. And my experience has been that they remain unattended, unsettled, and education suffers. The second observation I have to make is that in the states, the level and the quality of attention devoted to educational matters, to the management of education, if I may use the word, both education, both at the school level and at the college level and at the professional level, is inadequate, to use a very moderate term. A, there is no political will, there is no interest. B, there is also lack of capacity to how to manage an educational institution. We are not invariably successful in managing even schools for the simple reason that we are not very clear on what exactly requires to be done. So I am raising this issue because in the context of the new education policy, very large implementational issues will arise. The questions of accreditation, when you defiliate the host of institutions presently in existence, you create a competition, hopefully. And hopefully, again, I would expect that we create an environment which is merit-oriented environment, where institutions which are truly meritorious and competent, they get higher ratings, they emerge as the best institutions to go to. Another problem which is bound to rise straight away, irrespective of the level of interest in the states, is question of resources. How are we going to deal with that? And third, again, is a messy issue. This is a question of vested interests. In the states which have witnessed a reasonable or a good deal of growth of the private sector in education, all manner of institutions have developed. And there is no uniformity of standards. There is a large problem in regard to the manner in which education is imparted, how degrees are imparted, how PhDs are awarded, and so on. So we shall have to battle with all these problems. Now, I'd given myself 10 minutes. I don't want to go on and on. But one last point is in my perception, when I was a student some 75 years ago, I would say that the role of the teacher, the role, the responsibility, the dignity that you attach to a primary school teacher, middle school teacher, a high school teacher, to a college lecturer, to a professor in a university, to the vice chancellor of university. Where do we place him in society? In my time, the teacher was poorly paid, as most others were in the professional areas in the British times, but held in high regard, high esteem, high respect. I remember that all my elders in the family, my father, my elder brothers, when they had to meet my teacher, for instance, the person who was teaching me or the school teacher, then it was not just an offhand matter. Somebody could just go and meet him like that. There was some procedure, there was some process, There was some dignity about the whole exchange. Today, unfortunately, while the salaries in the formal sector are fairly good, if I may say so, as compared to the time I was lecturer in the Punjab University, less than 200 rupees a month, I dare say that our teachers are well paid, well treated today, well regarded also. But as it happens, teacher's position is not what it I feel it should be. And most of all, to put it very briefly, if you made a vice chancellor responsible for the intellectual growth and development of 20,000, 30,000, 40,000 children, whether constituent or affiliated, and much larger number, what authority have you given him? Do you interfere in his work? The question, issues which relate to autonomy versus some kind of management of control systems, autonomy versus control, and least of all, which I hope that we are able to turn the leaf, is the enormous amount of political interference in the initial selection of teachers, school teachers by the thousand, by the lakh, if I may say so, then their appointments, then their transfers. Essential interest in education in the states relates to selections, appointments, and transfers, not to where the teacher teaches, what is the quality of teaching, what is available in the school or the college or the university. That seems to be nobody's business. So I will stop here. These are many questions, and I will now, it is 13 minutes past 4. I've crossed my limit by 3 minutes. I will now ask Professor Anurag Baer to please speak to us. Professor Baer.